Hey guys, Professor Bill, Comic Book University, and Terry Moore's 5 Years. Turns out this is a crossover book of a whole bunch of people in the Terryverse. I don't remember ever reading Terry Moore. I did not know this was a crossover until the very end of it. I decided to look up the book and see, is Terry Moore a guy or a girl? I'm realizing now I forgot to actually see if Terry Moore is a guy or a girl. But it was because I all of a sudden got caught up in the idea this is a multiverse crossover, a whole bunch of different characters together. It's called 5 Years. Basically, the book is made by Terry Moore. What do you call it? This being a crossover, basically the characters here discover that, oh no, the world is going to end in about 5 years because these people are making this hydrogen bomb, but it's actually called a phi bomb, but it's a kind of hydrogen bomb that actually destroys all the hydrogen that it touches, and it's chain reactive. So it's quite literally all of the hydrogen. Eventually, this hydrogen killer will reach the sun, which is half hydrogen, half helium. But even then, the helium is because of the hydrogen. So yeah, it's going to destroy everything. Everything in the universe, for the most part, gone. Only dark matter left, really, and a few composite molecules. Without hydrogen, you can't even reform the universe. It's sick, dude. Sick. So yeah, I loved this comic book. I didn't know who any of these characters were. I only recall one name from the book, Francine. That's the lover of the main character, what appears to be the main character. Then this this Marine is there, and she talks to a stuffed gorilla that she actually sees as being real and walking around. Because I gotta admit, I almost didn't read this book because I saw an effing gorilla on the front cover. I'm like, dude, not cool, dude. I'm not having it with the freaking gorillas. I'm serious, dude. Like, I looked at this. I'm just like, what's up? There's a walking, talking gorilla, so this isn't going to be real. So I looked at the book, and I was just shocked. Oh, this is Abstract Studios, by the way. And I was just shocked at how good this book was. I don't have any images to show you. I don't know if they put any online, any, you know, real ones. But it's all just pencil work. You know, with a little bit of inks in the background to show some shading. But, like, for the most part, it's just pencils, dude. And this book is gorgeous. I can't help but say the art is gorgeous, the story is gorgeous. Now, listen, if I would have known that this was a multiverse crossover and I didn't know who all these characters were, I wouldn't have read the book. So I'm glad that I didn't know. Because I read this book, and like I said, I didn't realize this was some kind of a crossover until I went and looked it up online. Which means you can read this book and you will perfectly understand what is going on without any extraneous details necessary. You can go back and read all of these other stories of these other characters that came out if you choose, but that's your choice. I would probably recommend it. Will I? Well, I read a lot of comic books as it stands, and there's a whole bunch of other comic books I need to catch up on, so to speak. It's funny, man. When I went to the Middle East, I lost touch with comic books, and this is the flaw in the system. The only real way to get comic books out there, to advertise comic books, has always been in comic books or in comic book stores, the solicits and whatnot. But they don't do advertisements in newspapers. Who reads newspapers anymore? They don't do internet ads or even TV ads, you know, archaic as it may sound. They don't do billboards. It just doesn't happen. It doesn't happen. The best way is for hoping it's going to become a movie, and then maybe somebody, you know, figures out, oh wow, I didn't realize that this was actually that this was based on a comic book. Maybe I'll go check out the comic book. Maybe. But I already saw the movie. This is one of the reasons why people like us are important. In my particular case, this is not, you know, going to be the greatest of reviews because I don't know anything about the prehistory of this comic book. And there's apparently a big history, you know, this Terryverse. But I'm sure there are other people out there who are more familiar with the rest of the Terryverse, and they can guide you a little bit better than I can. All I can say is grab this comic book. Really, grab this comic book. Enjoy it. You want to read what came before? Do it. You don't want to? Don't. But I felt perfectly comfortable reading this comic book and just being oblivious to everything else that came before it. Because the book is written in such a way that you don't need what came before. They explain everything perfectly fine. Going back in retrospect, it's amazing how well they explain this as though it was a first-time read. Meanwhile, a whole bunch of other people can look at this and just right away go, yeah, I know all these characters. This is an awesome introduction to this cool story. It's a good book. Definitely consider checking it out. And for all you comic book creators out there, be nice to the people reviewing your comic books. I'm just saying, because, yeah, we love your stuff and we enjoy getting your stuff out there. Anyways, guys, yeah, good book. Go and check this out. 5 years, Terry Moore, Terryverse, crossover, without even realizing it. Professor Bill, Comic Book University, class dismissed.